the spot, so that's good. So far, we've seen a hedgehog. Brandon's bloodthirsty. He wanted to shoot it. This year, I'm going to try to keep my cool when the deer come out. I'm going to try not to have a panic attack, like I always do. We have an east wind, so we're hunting a setup where the wind is almost bad for us. But I think hunting this way with a crosswind, I think. We have bedding all around us. This is so ideal for early season. We got in here nice and early. Never stepped foot out here all year, so we're planning to hang, hunt, kill, drag, check station, quarter in the cooler. The gun jammed, but Brandon waited for that buck to get closer, let him walk in about, I don't know, about 100 yards at most. You want to hunt areas where the wind is kind of almost bad for you, but it's good for them. You're more likely to have an encounter as long as it's kind of like a crosswind or a diagonal kind of thing. But Brandon got it done, man. And you're like 4 for 4.
Yeah,
I mean, that's insane. He's never missed, this guy. Just backed it up, and it looks like a great shot. So I'm not going to
finish it up. I'm going to get this stuff down.
Yeah. All right, see you guys in a minute.
Oh, it's a little buck.
It is?
Yep.
All right, so basically we shot the deer and it probably ran like 15 feet and started spurting out blood over here and then fell over and died right here. And here's my buck.
This is my 7-point.
And it's velvet. What the heck is it doing with velvet on it?
No.
Look at the blood on the antler and everything. That is weird. And field dressing his own deer. Look at the steam rolling out of that thing.
How do you get these up? How I feel it in my hand.
You reach as high as you can and pull with one hand and then cut with the other. Yep, you wanna don't cut your hand.
I'm gonna get it over. Get rinsed out.
Oh, there.
Ah.
Bolt's still there.
That hole.
Brandon has an older brother, and I think youth season is awesome. And a lot of people I know are against youth season because you take a youth out early, and you're shooting a gun, and a lot of people think it mucks up the whole season. And you know, that's true in a lot of respects, but it just depends on how you hunt according to the pressure and all that. I'm not going to get into that. But I just think when you introduce a new hunter, or a youth especially, the number one thing you got to remember is keep it fun. You see, Brandon's older brother, I pushed him a little bit harder. I know, I seen it. I put my goals on him. I just wanted him to know all this
stuff
about hunting.
As Brandon,
I let him, you know, just pick out the deer he wanted to, and I think that worked a little bit better. The last thing I want anybody to do is make the same mistake I made. And it's just so important that you need to let the new hunter have their own goals and grow as a hunter. You know, the world isn't going to end if they shoot a couple younger deer before
and you're thinking
to
older deer.
I'm a trophy hunter, that's who I am, and I want to pass that on to my kids. And I understand, I couldn't agree more. I am the same way, but I have been hunting almost 20 years now. And it took me to, if I were to sit in a stand for 5-10 years with never shooting my bow and never harvesting an animal, never putting food on the plate, I think I would have given
it
the sport
up. It means
the world to a new hunter to harvest their first buck. Any buck, especially their first buck, is going to be a big deal. And shooting a young deer, that allows, or shooting a smaller deer allows that hunter to set the goal
higher. And if somebody wants to go out and say, I'm not going to shoot a buck until I see just a magnificent animal, I respect that too.
So, but I just wanted to say that before, that's what youth season really was about for me. It was a learning experience. Again, you know, having the two boys, I had that opportunity. So somebody that maybe only has one kid, maybe you can use that. So to everybody who watched this, thank you very much for watching this much, this far. And on the next video, I was going to actually process the deer and show you how we cool it and actually get the deer and retrieve it. But I'll put that on the next video. So whoever wants to watch that, be sure to subscribe. And if you could click like, I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time. Don't care where it goes.